new psychological study from the National Institute of Mental Health.
Just this morning, along with his longtime psychiatrist.
The circle of depression is growing wider, broader.
15% of women suffer from this disorder.
Over 20 million Americans. Changes that have occurred in the
abnormalities in the neurotransmitters.
Is that a chemical imbalance?
Got a problem. They've got a drug.
6 million American kids take prescribed medication.
Psychiatric care.
But what if the criminal is mentally ill?
The punishment, a form of aversion therapy.
10 in a cure zone show, but I want to
seasonal affective disorder.
OCD.
Oppositional defiant disorder.
Schools criticized for overprescribing.
I'm going to go.
Ihr Einfluss ist überall spürbar. Sie glauben, die Psychiatrie hätte nichts mit Ihnen zu tun? Dann schauen Sie einmal genau hin. Es gibt keinen Teil Ihres Lebens, nach dem die Psychiatrie nicht greift.
They basically believe that everyone is mentally ill.
You smoke too much, it's a disease. You are too unhappy, it's a disease. You're too thin, it's a disease. You're too fat, it's a disease.
Where are these coming from? These are coming from the minds of psychiatrists that are dreaming these things up. Writing papers and getting published with their names on it, calling creating these new diseases.
First he said that I had ADD. Then he said that I was depressed. Then he said I might be bipolar, but I don't have ADD anymore.
And he said, you know, I've been noticing you, and I wonder if you have it too.
What they decided is that both my husband and my son had a chemical imbalance that needed to be corrected with a chemical balancer.
There is not one shred of credible evidence that any respectable scientist would consider valid, demonstrating that anything that psychiatrists call mental illness are brain diseases or biochemical imbalances. It's all fraud.
There is no reliability of diagnosis, and there is no science. It's just pseudoscience. It's pretend science.
This is one of the most open secrets in all of America in the psychiatric field, that nothing is being done that's legitimate, and they're billing for it.
Psychiater behaupten, weltweit würden über 1 Milliarde Menschen an psychischen Krankheiten leiden. In den letzten 30 Jahren verdreifachte sich die Anzahl der Menschen, die Psychopharmaka nehmen, auf gegenwärtig über 100 Millionen Verbraucher. Und im Moment werden weltweit 20 Millionen Schulkindern Stimulantien und andere psychotropische Medikamente verschrieben. Bei einer kürzlichen Befragung zur wissenschaftlichen Grundlage ihres Berufs hatten diejenigen Psychiater, die bereitwillig antworteten, nur Ausreden parat.
Psychiatric illness is not really illness.
How do you evaluate if someone is cured or sick?
Cure is certainly something we look forward to. We had no earthly idea how to accomplish.
We're not good at causes. We don't know what causes mental illness.
Das hat Psychiater aber nicht davon abgehalten, sich als Experten für psychische Gesundheit auszugeben und Menschen gegen ihren Willen zu behandeln. Was sind die Ergebnisse?
This psychiatrist, man who's supposed to work to heal people, has done nothing but destroy this man's life, and in destroying his life, destroying the lives of all of his loved ones. Excuse me.
They've damaged and ruined my son, and they've trapped him in a system.
The way that they treated him and made him feel like he was worthless.
Riot was being kept dumb and high on Ritalin so that they could make $2,500 per month.
He gave me Valium, and I got addicted to it.
It wiped out my life.
My life has been ruined. My joy has been stolen.
She was lying there. She took two gasps of air and died right there in front of me.
It is really tragic. It's awful. And it's being done for money. That's why it's being done.
Oh, it's got to be in the billions. I don't know the exact number, but it's got to be in the billions. It's just unbelievable.
This is so big that it boggles the mind.
Die hier gezeigten menschlichen Tragödien zeigen nur die Spitze eines Eisbergs von unglaublichen Ausmaßen. In den letzten 4 Jahrzehnten starben beinahe doppelt so viele Amerikaner in staatlich finanzierten Psychiatrien als amerikanische Soldaten in Kampfhandlungen seit 1776. In den USA zahlen die Regierung und private Versicherungen jährlich 72 Milliarden Dollar für das psychiatrische System, wodurch die Versicherungsbeiträge erheblich inflationieren. Die Psychiatrie kassiert in Amerika jährlich mehr als 250 Billionen Dollar obwohl sie keinen einzigen Heilerfolg vorweisen kann. Schwer zu glauben? Genau darauf baut die Psychiatrie. Seit ihren Anfängen ist die Psychiatrie mit ihren unmenschlichen Praktiken davongekommen, weil man sie nur schwer als Realität begreifen kann.